I'm Jen Schiffer. I'm the community engineer for Glitch.com here at Fog Creek. We call Glitch the friendly community where you'll build the app of your dreams. But what is an app, and how do you build it? And how do you get it online so that other people can see what you've created? We're hoping that with this video series, you will leave with an understanding of that. We're going to introduce you to languages like HTML, CSS, and JavaScript to build your first app, and also teach you how stuff gets on the web and how you can program that using Node. We're going to be using Glitch.com, of course. It's an in-browser editor where you can write all this code front-end and server-side, and it auto-deploys, so you don't have to know any DevOps stuff.
HTML is used to add content to pages. So for example, if you'd like to add a paragraph of text to your web page, you're going to add that text between two HTML tags. You're going to use a starting tag to start the paragraph. So in this case, it's going to be a P sandwiched between two triangle brackets. You'll add your text. For example, I might say something like, "Hi, my name is Nikki." And if that's the end of my paragraph, I'm going to want to close that with a closing tag so that HTML as a language knows that that paragraph is over. That closing tag is going to look like the opening tag, except it's going to have a slash in front of the P.
So we're starting out with intro to HTML. It's just an HTML app on Glitch, a static site. We're not looking at any server-side code. And we're starting by looking at the readme.md file. Here I give info on what the app is, and a short introduction to HTML, very short introduction, and then a little bit about the files that are in the project. So let's take a look at what the site actually does. You can click the Show Live button, and we see our app live on the internet at intro2html.glitch.me. So I created a New Year's resolution app where I say the status of my New Year's resolution. And I have a link to another page where I talk about my resolution and have an image asset here. And this is all HTML content. So index.html is a page that we go to when we first go to our app. My HTML starts with a doc type telling the browser I'm going to use HTML. I start with an HTML tag, and I end with an HTML tag. And inside is all the content on my page. We have the head section, which is info for the browser. So we have a title tag saying, "Am I keeping my New Year's resolution?" And that's what we see when we look at the tab of our browser. The body of the page, which is within the body tag in HTML, is what we see on the window, which is right here, all this white space with content inside of it, including on our homepage. My homepage has a header tag with a link to the about.html document. So we have the A tag here, and then we have that attribute, href, which says what the URL or what document we should go to.
Sometimes an HTML tag is going to need more than just the content that's in between the opening and closing tags. This additional content is called attributes. So for example, if you're adding an image to a web page and you're going to use HTML to do that, you're going to start out with an IMG tag. So that's going to be similar to the paragraph tag I mentioned earlier. But something that you might want to add as an attribute to that IMG tag is a source, which is going to be SRC, and that's just going to tell you where that image is coming from. So it could be a web link, it could be a file path to a specific image that you're using.
And I have a paragraph with my date and my status. So if I wanted to update this to any sort of day of the month it may be, I would do that. And Glitch auto-deploys, so you don't have to refresh the browser or do anything else. It will just update it to January 5th. And you can also update your status. And you go to that page, and the status shows up as you had typed it. Our about.html page has all of our about page content. I included a link back to the home page. It has the same title. It has a couple of paragraphs. And here we have an image. Our image tag in HTML requires a source attribute, which is the source of the image, and an alt attribute, which is a description of the image. And so in my case, this is an illustration of a stack of books, and the source is this long URL. In Glitch, if you go to assets, you can drag to the window or upload through this button any asset. In this case, I have this book's image, and I copied the URL and pasted it into the HTML on about.html. And that's it. We have some content on our page. It doesn't look nice, But we'll use CSS to do that.
Yeah, HTML has some limitations. You can really only use it to add content to a web page. So if you want to make your page do anything, you can't use HTML. Also, the syntax is pretty rigid. So if you are trying to add a paragraph, you really have to use that opening and closing P tag. There's no other way to do that. And the syntax can be a little bit confusing to a beginner, especially remembering to add those closing tags to everything.
In this first video, we talked about HTML, what it is, what its limitations are, and then we went over some actual HTML code in the Intro to HTML app. You can take that and add more content to your own liking. And in the next video, we're going to talk about CSS. We're going to make Intro to HTML look a bit nicer.